you care for and protect your home? Like most people, you probably clean it regularly and make repairs whenever something breaks. Maybe you proactively invest in waterproofing, weather stripping, and insulation to protect against the elements. Or maybe you use storm shutters, alarms, or insurance policies to guard against the worst-case scenario. Protecting our home is sort of second nature, since it also means protecting those who live in it. Fort Matanzas National Monument preserves the 18th century Spanish fortification that once protected the southern mouth of the Matanzas River. Like nearby Castillo de San Marcos, Fort Matanzas safeguarded the city of St. Augustine and was itself a home for many intrepid settlers at the time. But the park also protects about 300 acres of coastal ecosystems, containing dunes, marshes, and maritime forests. Numerous animals, including threatened and endangered wildlife like lease terns, sea turtles, and the Anastasia Island beach mouse, make a home of these environments. And, like us, they rely on their homes for food, shelter, and protection. But today, climate change is bringing big impacts to communities along the Florida coast, including the natural environments of Fort Matanzas. Continual erosion from incremental sea level rise, coupled with greater storm surge from tropical storms, have resulted in the loss of valuable habitat. For example, when rolling dunes are eroded into steep scarps, sea turtles can't access safer nesting sites on higher ground and are forced to deposit eggs within reach of the waterline. These nests are often washed out by king tides or the passage of strong storms. Given such realities, it's more important than ever to care for and protect the shoreline home of our coastal wildlife. Surprisingly, many of the same strategies we use at home can help us respond to challenges posed by a warming world. We can clean up as we go and fix things as they break, or we can think proactively about how to protect against the elements. And we can even begin to make plans now in the event of a worst-case scenario. For example, park staff are taking steps to help make sustainable operations second nature. Managers are also intentionally leaving woody debris on the beach to help trap sand and build dunes over time. And they're also planting large numbers of sea oats in an effort to stabilize dunes and help hold sand in place during extreme weather. During your visit to Fort Matanzas, you too have an important role to play. Both footsteps and car tires damage plants and destroy delicate root fibers. Staying off the dunes during your visit allows native plants to take root, flourish, and guard against erosion. With over 500,000 people visiting the park every year, the small things we do can make a big difference. What other actions should we make second nature to protect the future of the homes and habitats most important to us? Can you picture it?